Outriders is finally out, and we get our first look at how the crafting in the game really works. Hello, people of the internet. My name is Mags, and today we're taking a deep look at crafting in the game of Outriders, and it's pretty amazing. Before we get started with the video, if you're new around here and like what you see, consider subscribing to the channel. And if you do enjoy the video, leave a like. It really helps me out. Also, I'm gonna be streaming the entire story of Outriders right here on my YouTube channel. Make sure that you're subscribed and have notifications turned on so you know when I go live. But without further ado, let's get into the video. Crafting in Outriders is going to be the way to take your builds to the next level. For some things like swapping out mods, it's incredibly easy to do. However, other things like raising the level of your weapons and gear can become extremely costly. Today, we're gonna go over everything you need to know about crafting because trust me when I say you are going to want to get into crafting your gear the moment you unlock it. Crafting is unlocked via an in-game vendor named Zahidi. You will go on a rescue mission to get him fairly early on and then can use him at your camp no matter where you travel. Crafting isn't necessarily the term I'd use for this system as it's more of a modification system of sorts, but to understand all that we're able to do, let's take a look at a piece of gear. On your standard piece of gear, both weapons and armor, there are a few things that we can look at that will affect the way that these change your stats. First up is the level. This is the current level of your gear. This can be higher than your current level if you are up there in world tiers. Next, we have variant. This one is specifically for weapons. Each weapon has several variant types that will affect the way the weapon works. Beyond that, we have your total firepower or armor. Like the name states, these weapons and armor have overall values that they add to your characters. Below these are substats. These in the game are called attributes. Each weapon or armor piece that is of green quality or better will have attribute values. The higher tier of gear, the more attributes you can have. Underneath your attributes are mod slots. These mods are used to change the way your weapon and armor work. You can do things like put burning rounds on your bullets, or for armor, give yourself an extra chance to use your abilities. For armor mods, please note that these mods are class specific. Beyond that, we have things like overall weapon info, which is obviously specific for the weapons. These can be clip size, fire rate, reload speed, etc. Now, some items have symbols on them, which denote different things. If you see this wrench and screwdriver icon, that means that this item has been modified via crafting in some way. If you see this window pane icon, it means that you've already discovered this mod and it's inside of your mod library. And if you see this shard icon, it means that if you dismantle this piece of armor or this weapon, you will get some shards in this attribute category. Now that we know what to look for on our gear, let's talk about how to get mods and shards. Mods and shards are needed to upgrade your gear and make them more potent. In order to unlock mods to use in crafting, you'll need to dismantle gear that has mods on it. Remember the window pane icon I talked about? If you see a piece of gear without this icon, that means you do not currently own this mod. You will want to dismantle this piece of gear to get that mod. Once you have the mod unlocked, you can add it to whatever piece of gear you want. Shards are what you need to raise the attribute values or the substats of your weapons or armor. You can get shards the same way that you would get mods, by dismantling gear. Outside of mods and shards, there are a few resources available to us in-game that we're going to need in order to craft. These resources are leather, which you can get from dismantling armor or defeating hostile animals. Iron, which you get from dismantling weapons or harvesting ore veins in the wild. And titanium, which can be dropped from elites you defeat on the field, dismantling epic and legendary items, and sometimes they can be dropped from the ore veins. Now that we know what resources we'll need, let's go over the crafting menu. Upon unlocking crafting, you'll be met with a menu to start selecting which modifications you want. First up, we have Improve Rarity. This option lets you increase the rarity of an item all the way up to epic. Improving the rarity of an item will cost different materials. Improving a green item into a blue item will cost either leather or iron if it's armor or a weapon, but increasing a blue item into a purple item will cost you titanium. When you improve the rarity of an item, the bonus attributes will be raised randomly. Also, if you choose to increase the rarity of an item, let's say a blue item into a purple item, that piece of gear will gain a mod slot, and the game will present you with 3 random mods you can choose from to add it to that piece of gear. Moving on, we have raise attributes. In this menu, we have access to increase the substats on a piece of gear. Each of these attributes has 6 levels which it can be upgraded. In order to upgrade your attributes, you will need to have enough shards in that category. For example, to increase the crit damage attribute, you will need to have crit damage shards. The game will tell you how much of each shard that you will need in order to raise the level. As an added bonus, if you raise the attributes of a piece of gear and then dismantle it, you will get back a portion of the shards that you spent. Next up, we have mod gear. This menu is so incredibly important throughout the whole of the game, so get familiar with how it works. When you mod a piece of gear, you will need resources, those being leather for armor and iron for weapons. The mods that you can add to your gear can only be ones that you discovered. Once you discover a mod, you're free to place this mod on any piece of gear that you wish. An important thing to note is that epic and legendary gear will come with 2 mod slots. You're able to change 1 of these slots. In doing so, the other mod slot will lock and you will be unable to change it. Also, mod effects don't stack, meaning if you put 2 of the same mod on your gear, even if it's on 2 different pieces, you will not get the added benefits. Make sure you check the mod name before adding it to your piece of gear. Under the mod menu, we have swap variant. This is a menu used exclusively for weapons. Each weapon in this game has several variants that you can switch between. You will have access to more variants as you level up in the game, but these weapon variants can do things such as change the rate of fire of a weapon, the clip size, the damage per round, etc. Experiment with each different weapon variant to see which ones you like the most and fit your playstyle. Finally, in the crafting menu, you will have the power to level up a weapon. Say you've crafted a great weapon mid-game and wanted to raise it to your current level or use it for endgame. In this menu, you can spend titanium to raise the level of this item up to your current wearable gear level. Titanium is a relatively precious resource, so if you're raising the level of a weapon or a piece of armor, make sure it's one that you really want. Crafting in Outriders is super important and worth every resource you spend, but there are a few tips that I would like to leave you with to make your experience around crafting just a little bit better. Sell everything early. Unless it has a mod that you need. The bread and butter of crafting, in my opinion, is 100% in the mods you unlock. That being said, if a piece of gear drops and it already has a mod that you've unlocked, sell it instead of dismantling it. Later on into the game, there'll be vendors that will sell epic level items, both weapons and armor, and these pieces of gear are expensive. In order to purchase them, you will need scrap and lots of it. For this reason, make sure that you're collecting everything that drops and selling off whatever you don't need at the vendors. Once you have enough scrap, you can purchase the higher level items that the vendors have on offer, even if you aren't planning on using them. You can then dismantle these items for tier 2 mods to use later in the game. Some of these mods are incredible for damage output and can do some serious work. Once you start getting higher tier items with mods you already have, you can dismantle those for the titanium. Shards are a great way to squeeze out some extra stat values, but I wouldn't rely on them over mods. So for some of the more rare shards, save them until you're able to find a piece of gear that you really want to max out. And finally, change out your mods often. You will continue to unlock powerful skills, and those skills can become devastating with the right mods equipped. Make sure that you're changing out your mods, especially armor mods, to complement your builds accordingly. I think that pretty much covers the basics of crafting and how to utilize it properly. Remember, crafting in Outriders is a necessity, especially in the higher world tiers. You really want to get your gear to work for you, and it's incredibly easy to do. Experiment with crafting to perfect your build. Trust me. You're gonna need it. With that, we are at the end of the video. Let me know in the comments section below what one of your favorite mods is. Remember to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and turn on notifications so you know when I post a new video or go live. As always, I'm Mags, and I will see you in the next one.